In this video, we will describe how to use GlowGerm to perform a hands-on disease transmission and biosecurity activity. This activity is designed to simulate ways that diseases might spread among people and animals. The activity guide with discussion questions can be found on bluenotflu.org. This activity will take about 10 minutes to set up and about 20 to 30 minutes to complete. You may complete this activity with any number of participants. It is best to have a table or other surfaces to set things down on for this activity. Lighter colored, hard floors and surfaces will hide the GlowGerm better and make cleanup easier. It is also beneficial to be near a bathroom, sink, or hand washing station. Before participants arrive, sprinkle GlowGerm across the doorway or doorways that participants will enter through. It is best if the door remains closed before participants enter, so they are less likely to notice the GlowGerm powder and alter their normal behaviors when interacting with their environment. For this reason, it is also best to place the bottle of GlowGerm and the black light in a concealed location when participants arrive. This activity is best done in stages, with the participants unknowingly interacting with the GlowGerm-coated supplies prior to the discussion taking place. Once you are ready to begin the activity with participants, have them interact individually or in groups with the GlowGerm-coated supplies. For older audiences, one strategy is to have each participant speak only when holding the stuffed animal. For example, you could have each participant introduce themselves while holding the stuffed animal, or you could play a game such as Name a Fomite, where participants are asked to identify one item around a farm that might spread disease before passing the stuffed animal to a new person who then has to name a different item. Younger participants may enjoy being divided into groups and being asked to get their animal ready for a show. They do this by inspecting their animal to make sure it is not sick, they mix up feed for the animal, and collect equipment to bring to the show. If you are doing an activity that requires moving around the room, you may also get better results by waiting until that activity is completed before beginning the discussion for this activity. Once participants have interacted with the GlowGerm on the stuffed animal and other supplies and tracked the GlowGerm around the room, bring out the black light for a discussion of how easily disease can move through fomites. Turn the lights in the room off and shine the black light on the floor and on the bottom of participants' shoes. Explain that they all had the same single source of exposure for this spread, the entryway to the room. Participants should also recognize that if they interact directly with the source of infection, the stuffed animal in this case, they may also be responsible for spreading disease. Shine the black light on the stuffed animal, as well as on participants' hands and clothes. If not already discussed, you may ask participants about other fomites or potential sources of spread. As they name items, shine the black light on the supplies, such as the brushes. Mention that both animal feed and human food, the popcorn in this case, can be especially problematic because the pathogen can be introduced into the body of the person or animal through ingestion. If time and facilities allow, you may also have participants wash their hands, then re-examine their hands under the black light to demonstrate the importance of thorough hand washing. You may also repeat this activity after participants put on personal protective equipment, or PPE. This addition has limitations for participants with GlowGerm already on them, but could be performed with the assistance of a participant teacher or volunteer who has not yet entered the room and come into contact with the GlowGerm. This can be followed by a discussion of how wearing proper PPE helps prevent disease transmission. Once participants have a good understanding of the way that diseases can spread, conclude the activity with further discussion of disease prevention by covering the items under discussion in your instructor guide. For more information and additional activities, visit bluenotflu.org.